What were the vessels like that Captain Vancouver sailed in? A European ship in the 1700s was made from a variety of different wood. The frame of the vessel was made from white oak because of its strength and resistance to rotting. The decks and hull planking were made from cedar or fir. And Sitka spruce was preferred for the masts and spars, as they could more easily bend without breaking into heavy winds. A mast would be stepped into the keel and then secured in place by shrouds and stays made from tar-covered hemp rope. Vessels like this needed a lot of looking after, so crew included a number of carpenters. Masts and spars would frequently need to be replaced. Leaks were a constant concern. In Vancouver's time, the vessel's bottom was also sheathed in copper to protect it against Teredo worm, which is a saltwater clam that burrows into the timber. The copper bottom also helped a ship to slip faster through the water. European vessels were powered by the wind using a combination of four-sided square sails and triangular lateen sails made from canvas. The design of these vessels evolved from Venetian, Roman, and Viking boats that originally sailed along the European coastline. By the 16th century, bigger vessels with enclosed decks were developed to cross the ocean. Square sails were more commonly used for long ocean crossings because they captured more wind. On the downside, a square-rigged ship ideally needed to have the wind coming from behind or beside it. Because sailors had to go aloft to change the sails, which means climbing up the rigging, these vessels required large crews. There was also a strong possibility of losing seamen from falling off the rigging and going overboard. Sadly, it was not always possible to go back and find them. Captain Vancouver had two vessels for his expedition: His Majesty's Ship Discovery, HMS Discovery for short, and HMS Chatham. Both vessels were ideal for survey work. They had shallow drafts, which meant they could get in close to shore. They also had rounded, nearly flat bottoms, which meant they would be less likely to roll over if they did become grounded. That's very handy when you're sailing in unknown waters. The Discovery was about 100 feet long and 28 feet across. It was very similar to Captain Cook's ship, HMS Endeavour. The design was based on a collier, a ship that transports coal. Consequently, the hull was very strong and there was a large amount of space below deck. The Chatham was half the size, about 50 feet long and 22 feet across. As a general rule, the bigger the sail area and the longer the vessel, the faster it will go. The Discovery had a top speed of 8 nautical miles in 1 hour. That's about 15 kilometers per hour. The Chatham was a brig, which meant it was rigged mostly with square sails on two masts. The Discovery was a fully rigged ship, which meant it was rigged mostly with square sails on three masts. The British Navy classified these vessels as sloops of war, which meant they had less than 20 large guns. The Discovery had 10 guns and the Chatham had 4. By comparison, a first-rate British Navy warship from this period would have over 100 large guns and was roughly twice the size of Discovery. The Discovery had a crew of 100 men, which included 9 ship's officers, 38 able seamen to sail the ship, a military force of 16 Marines, and skilled tradesmen such as carpenters, sailmakers, cooks, servants, gunners, and a surgeon. The Chatham had a crew of 45 in a similar combination of officers, seamen, Marines, and tradesmen. Life on board both vessels would have been very cramped. Why are square sails uncommon today? By the 1800s, multiple mast schooners were becoming popular, particularly for trading and fishing vessels. They employed a fore and aft rig. This meant that rather than having the sails positioned across the ship using spars, the sails ran along the length of the ship using booms. Less crew was needed on a schooner because the sails could be changed on deck. No crew was needed to go aloft. The fore and aft sails also allowed the vessel to sail closer to the wind, which means it could sail with the wind nearer to the bow of the ship. This ultimately shortened the length of the journey. Modern sailing yachts today still use a fore and aft sail rig. They also have metal masts and deeper keels, which can support much larger sails. Unlike vessels in Captain Vancouver's time, ships today usually have a lot fewer cannons.